I've already downloaded fresh copy of Laravel app. If you want to learn how to download Laravel app, click on this link. Open Start menu. Search for CMD. Right-click on CMD. Run it as administrator. Navigate to the app directory. Run the app by typing php space artisan space serve. As you can see, this is a fresh copy of Laravel. It does not have anything. Let's add the view for dashboard and sign up and login. It's quite simple. Just type in php space artisan space make colon auth. Press the enter key. Run the local development server again to see the changes. Refresh the web page. Great! We now have home page, login page, and you can reset your password. But first, you must sign up using the register page. Sign up means storing data. Login means checking the data. For this purpose, I need to use MySQL to create a database for holding my own data. So, run the WAMP server as administrator. Navigate to phpMyAdmin. Click on New. Choose a name for your database. I'll call it BlogDB. Click on Create. That's all. You don't have to bother yourself with creating table structures. Laravel will take care of this for you by using two files inside migrations of database folder. You have to tell your Laravel app the detail for connecting with MySQL and populating those tables with the new database we've just created by editing the environment file .env. Database connection, it's MySQL. Database host, it's local MySQL server. Database port 3306, it's the default port for MySQL server. All I have to change here, the database name, blogdb, the database username, root, and the database password. I don't use password. Save the file. Back to the command prompt, type in php space artisan space migrate. This command will populate the database with tables. Run the local development server by typing php artisan serve. Click on register link. I'll create an account. Also, there is validation process on these fields. For example, the password must be at least 6 characters. When I click on register button, I'll be registered and redirected with my credentials to the home page. There is a link to log out from my account. Let's log in with the new created credentials. Good. One last feature. Reset the forgotten password. Since I'm working locally, there is no need to use mail server right now. I'll just use my logs file. So go back to the environment file .env and edit the mail drive to use log. Save it. The logs will be saved in the storage logs directory. Every time you make some changes in your environment file, .env file, you have to stop your local development server and rerun it again. Refresh the web page. Now, insert your registered email to reset your password and click on Send Password Reset Link. We have emailed your password reset link. Good. Let's check the logs file. This data is meant to be sent by email, but for local development, I save it in logs. Now, copy the reset link and paste it in your web browser address bar. Finally, just type your new password with confirming and click on Reset Password. That's all. Thanks for watching. Thank you.